Hey, welcome back again guys. This is our second video of Computer Vision plus Django video series. Actually, there are only two videos in this series. First was face detection with HARCascade file, and in this video we are going to use MTCNN to detect faces from our images. If you haven't watched our first video, then go to the link in the description section and click on the I button above right side, and you will jump to that video and watch it, and you will learn how to create web interface and how to create Django projects and all. Then you can come back here to learn how to use MTCNN. So in previous video we left our code here, so we used a HARCascade file. Here is a HARCascade frontal face default XML to detect our faces. So first, to use MTCNN model, you have to install a package which is MTCNN. So pip install MTCNN. So MTCNN is already installed in my system. So it is showing requirement already satisfied. So you can see Keras processing. So MTCNN is a deep learning based model. So MTCNN is installed in my system. So first we have to import it from mtcnn.mtcnn import mtcnn, capital MTCNN. So now we are going to delete this all stuff. We also don't need this also, so I'm going to delete it. First we have to create a object of MTCNN. So here I'm going to create detector. Detector is equal to capital MTCNN, and here I am going to specify minimum space face size is equal to 100. So minimum face will be detected as a 100 pixel. Then we have to do some changes here. So I already have deleted this code. Then what we will do, we will specify our faces is equal to detector dot. Here we have a method of detect faces. Then we will specify our numpy array of image, cv underscore image. So this is so easy. Now we will find the LAN of our images. So here LAN faces. So now it's all done. There is no more hard coding and all. So we have successfully done our implemented our MTCNN model in our existing project. So let's check it by running this project, python manage.py run server. I am going to delete this existing files so we can upload it again. Now there is no file. So you can see guys, use TensorFlow backend. It is showing some error that CUDA 64 DLL not found. Why this error is coming? Because my PC don't have any graphic card support. If you have any graphic card support, so there will be some additional settings. You can check out the settings on their official site on TensorFlow. So I have no GPU, that's why I'm getting this error. But it will be fine if you have any graphic card. And it will take some time to load MTCNN model. Okay, so now my model is ready. So let's check whether it's giving any error or not. So it is not giving any kind of error. So here you can see in our media directory there is no image yet. So let's import one image and check whether it's working fine or not. Again, go to example image. Here Captain America, upload image. So you can see success, image is submitted, and we will check in our XAMPP file, sorry, not in our media directory. You can see CaptainAmerica.jpg is successfully uploaded. Now we will check one more image. So let me cancel this first. This time we will use multiple face. Upload image. Now it is showing no image submitted because it has a multiple face. This time we will use Tony, upload image, image is submitted. You can see here Tony and Captain America's image is here, but there is no multiple face image. Let's check one more image, nature, upload image. no face detected, so it is also working fine. So this is how you can implement MTCNN in our existing project and how you can check or verify face in image before uploading it to the server. I hope you understand this video. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below. I will definitely solve your any problem regarding this project and any IT solutions. So thanks for watching. If you are new to this channel, if you are watching this video for first time, please hit that subscribe button so you can get notification for any new machine learning and artificial intelligence videos. So thanks for watching. I will see you in the next episode, next video, or next video series.